Hi folks, this is Dan and I'm going to talk to you about, this is class exercise number two, task C. I assume that you have read through task A and B already, but before we get started and you take a look at this again, this is, let me explain with what you're trying to do. What you're trying to do is, in this particular task, you got to follow the step-by-step for me. And I ask you to create the same file structure as what you did for me in your class exercise task C with that file structure. Same thing with it as well. So here's what I just follow along with me. Do exactly what I ask you to do. And after this, you're welcome to name your file structure the way how you want it. I don't care. But for this exercise, if you can please just follow along and create things as you want to with it. So after this exercise, you're welcome to create your own your own file structure. You can call anything you want with it on your computer with what you're doing with it. So you know, just follow along. It's very difficult for you if you start to name things different, and it's not going to parallel with what I'm going to say. That's very important. The first thing I want to talk to, I took a screenshot of what you are trying to do. Is this is a screenshot of FileZilla, and the left-hand side is your local computer, the right-hand side is on the server. What you're trying to do is to keep a mirror image, meaning that if I place a mirror in the middle of this to it here, both of the file structure looks the same. So whatever's in your local computer here has the same image, same file structure up in the server. So let me define a little bit what does it mean by a file structure. File structure means you have files and you have subdirectories and subfiles, and inside it contains the exact same files. It's directories and files are together make what's called file structure. All right. So if you notice here, the only file that's floating outside is index.html. Everything else is inside our subdirectories, similar like your task C. Now, I just want to explain with a couple of stuff with it. So all of this, this is your local side, the left top and bottom here. The left side is on your local drive. So I created a subdirectory called imed1316. You can call it whatever you want. I don't care. Again, for now, imed1316. If you're in 1416, then call it 1416. It doesn't matter. It has subdirectories. Its subdirectories are, you see how these things are all lined up equally? None of them are contained inside. There's only one of them that I have. I created a subdirectory. It doesn't matter. But notice all the subdirectories are indented in, and these belong to the parent directories, imed1316. So you create, up to you, you create your own subdirectory with your dates. Now, these are the dates based off of spring 2020. This video is designed for all future use as well. So whatever the current date that you're using, use those with it as well. So here's what I recommend. Here's what I recommend. For my online students, create based off of the first Sunday of the week. So I would recommend you, for example, February the 2nd, 20. So that's, you know, considers February the 2nd. That's the first Sunday of every week. If you want to do that, that's fine. Here is the 2nd right here, okay? And then next week you create February the 9th. Next week you create February the 16th, so on and so on. For my on-campus students that are taking this on campus, create the directory on that day. If it's a Monday, Wednesday class, whatever the day falls on in this case, if it's a Monday, it happens to be the 3rd. If it's a Wednesday, it's going to be the 5th, so on and so on. All right, so it's up to you. I mean, but again, my naming convention, I ask you to name this as 020220. You notice I ask you not to put in any special characters, meaning dots or slashes or anything like that. All right, so that's very important. That's very important that you follow this naming structure with it. The other piece is that what you're going to notice that there's only one index file here. This is the index file that we created back in when you created the video how to create index from part 1A, 1B. That was the video section for it. It was at that table that had basically a plain wafer, nothing inside it with it. So let me check the time really quick. Hang on. Yeah, a few minutes. So it was that table that I want to show you is this table right here. Remember this file right here that we created with it? You're gonna fill this in today, okay? This is your index page right here. All right. This index page right here is this index page right here. That's what you're gonna do, right? So before we move on, this is the first thing we need. The second thing I need for you is to establish a connection with FileZilla. So you should, some way, somehow, you should have a document that I email you that has the filing format. So I basically capture, sent this to you. This will vary. Make sure this will vary. Make sure you have the right course link to it. This is your username. Again, let me clarify. This is going to be on the test. This is the protocol, all the way up to here. HTTP colon forward slash forward slash. That's the hypertext transfer protocol. This is the domain part, all the way up to EDU. Okay. From this part to this part is what's called the path, PATH, and that's the path. Our web server is defaulted to index.html. Don't worry, I built a web server, so I know exactly what it is with it. All right, your number is going to vary. It's going to be web, whatever the four digit it happens to be. You have to copy and paste this host address into the host right here, and you type in the web user ID and whatever the password I gave you. You copy and paste in here, and you click on Quick Connect. After you connect, this is what's supposed to look like. Again, this is the left side of your local drive, and this is what the server side looks like. You will replace this index page with yours. You will replace this index page with yours here. Okay. So if you cannot connect to the web server, you need to actually review the video how to connect to an FTP server, that segment with it. There should be a default HTML index HTML page, and you will replace it with yours with it. Before you get started, we need these two step. The file structure needs to look like this, and the FTP connection. Okay, so I'm preparing to. You need to complete those two before we move on. Cool? All right.